Dear students, welcome to the assignment where now we are going to see how to write a procedure in 64-bit assembly language program. So till now we have seen how to use the macros. Now procedures are something better than the macro, because in macro our instruction set is limited and the task which we need to perform in macro is considerably less as compared to the procedure. Also there is difference between the difference in execution strategy of the macro and procedure. Procedure follows control transfer, but in macro it doesn't happen in that way. In macro, whatever your macro definition is, it's expanding at the time of calling. So when you call a procedure, actually you are performing a control transfer, but when you call a macro, control transfer is not performed. At that line only your code is being expanded. So in this tutorial we'll start with we'll see one procedure which help us in displaying the value on the output. Okay, and we will consider that we will display that value in either hex number or in decimal number or in any other number. So to begin with we'll consider we want to display a number in hexadecimal number system format. Okay, so let's start with writing the procedure. Suppose I assign the name to that procedure is display. So procedure is starting in with the procedure name. No any special keyword is required like proc or something. So with return instruction you will identify that yes, it is a procedure. So we'll start with the very first label of your procedure, that is display. We'll start writing the instructions for it. So and at the same time I will explain you the logic behind it. So as earlier I have stated that we want to display a number which will get displayed in hexadecimal number system. Okay, so the logic which we are going to use here is we'll divide that number by 16, is that base of the hexadecimal number system, and we'll work on the whatever remainder we are getting, and then accordingly we'll calculate the equivalent or the equivalent hexadecimal number. Okay, so for that reason we need to perform the division operation, and so we need to use the division instruction of the assembly level program. So in division, as we all know, it works like RAX will be divided by RBX. Okay, so numerator and denominator is fixed, so division will take two operand where RAX will get divided by RBX. So as we need to convert the number into hexadecimal, so we'll take the BX value as 16 because we want our output in hex value. So very first instruction is assigning the values, appropriate values to the registers. Then next is how many digits you want your number should be. So that will nothing but your counter. So here I am considering I want to produce my number as in 2-digit format, so I have taken the counter as 2. Then now here I am pointing to the last location of my whatever number I am going to produce. So this is first we'll write the instruction and then we'll explain you. Now what is this character answer is? So character answer is the variable which we are going to use to store the converted number during the procedure. So during the conversion, during procedure execution, our number will get converted and it will get stored into character answer, and this character answer we will use to store the number. So as we have stated, our number is 2-digit, so this character answer size should be of 2 byte, because 1 digit equivalent to 1 character, that is 1 byte. So character answer is of 2 byte. Now here we don't know the value of that character answer, but yes, we know the name, we know the size, so it will be definitely declared in section.bss. So here we can declare the character answer like the way of reserving or the declaring variables in BSS is different. In dot data we are defining the exact size, like DB is defined bytes. Here we are reserving the size. So RE stands for reserve, this B stands for byte. So how many bytes you want to reserve? 2, and that's why it is being written as reserve bytes 2 for this variable character answer. Okay, so let's proceed with. And second thing, why we actually pointed to the last location? Okay, so let's graphically I will show you. Suppose this is character answer variable. This is the 0th index and this is the first index. If I want to work on the indexing part of that, so here my first digit and here second digit will be stored. Now I am, what I am doing, I am pointing RSI to the last byte of the character answer, because in division whatever output we are getting, it is from the LSB side, and so it will get stored on to this LSB side. So we are pointing our RSI, or we are storing the last byte address into RSI. Okay, so now move towards the next set of instruction. Now we want to use the division. So before display, what we will assume that our number is present into AX, because division it takes two operand AX and BX. So divisor we already taken as 16. So AX will assume that our number is present into AX, and now we'll use the division instruction. Before that, division store its output in two different register. It is RDX and RAX. So RDX is used for remainder, and in AX it is quotient. So first we'll make that RDX contain 0 to avoid any garbage value. Okay. So next we can call this division instruction. So DIV RBX. Here one operand is explicit, one is implicit, and so the syntactical way of writing the division instruction is like this: division RBX. So here our division will get occurred. So we'll just write the how it actually works. RAX will get divided by RBX, and our output, so RDX will be used to store the remainder, and RAX will be used to store the quotient. So here our division will occur, and now our remainder is present into DX. So as it is a one digit, so we can work on the lower part of the DX, that is DL, because of one byte. So we'll compare it here with that DL with 9. The reason is hexadecimal consists of two ranges. First range is 0 to 9 and second is your A to F. Again, this can be capital or this can be small. Okay, so here we need to check whether that remainder is in between 0 to 9 or A to F. The reason is because the value could not be passed to the output console as it is. It has to be passed in ASCII format. So for example, after division my remainder is 5. So I should pass its equivalent ASCII to the console, so that my console will understand that yes, this is the number which I want to display. Okay, so here we will compare it. So if our number is between 0 to 9, then to convert it into actual ASCII, we need to add the 30. So we'll take one label at 30 name, and we will add 30H if that number is between 0 to 9. Suppose it is not between 0 to 9. Okay, suppose it is not between 0 to 9. So first we'll complete it. Jump if below or equal. Jump if below or equal means what? If it is below 9 or equal to 9, then go to this label and add 30H into it. But if it is not so, then 37H should get added. So here I will write one instruction to add only 7H. Why? Because first this 7H will get added, and then we have already written the code instruction for 30H. So this 7 plus 30, 37H will get added into the DL. So now currently whatever required ASCII is, that is present in DL. And now what we will do, we will move it to the location pointed by, or that address stored by the RSI. Means what? Now it will be stored here in this location. Okay, so we'll move that DL into RSI. Here I have written the RSI in square bracket because I want to refer it as a value, and so it has to be written in square bracket. After that, we will decrement RSI so that you will come from this to this. Now your RSI is pointing to first location. Along with RSI decrementation, you should decrement your counter as well. And till your counter becomes zero, you should repeat your loop. So from which line we should repeat? From this. So here I can add one label. Okay. Suppose I have added label like back. So what I will do? I will jump to the back. So this is how labels are useful to combine or to collectively represent the set of related set of instructions. So after this, after the iteration to iteration procedure, that control transfer will come out of this loop, and now we need to display our answer using the same print macro which we have used. So here now for print, my input variable is this character answer, length is 2, and for a procedure last it should end with return. Okay, so now we will call this procedure. Now we'll see how to call this. So in section.txt, very first we should have RAX with some specific value. Like let's consider that value is 20, and then we will call. So this syntax for calling the procedure is this. So call and procedure name. Procedure name here it is case sensitive. After that, you should terminate your execution. Now procedures can be written outside the text. Procedure can be the part of text section. Here I am following the way where I have written the procedure outside the text section. Now we'll see whether we are getting the output or not. So we'll rectify the error at 25. Okay. So what output we are getting? 14. We have given the input as 20. So what this 14 is hexadecimal equivalent of this 20. Now we'll iterate through this graphical representation. So here our RAX value is 20 as per our consideration in a program. Then this is our RAX. Then RBX value we have taken as 16. So very first iteration, our RAX will get divided by 16. So we'll get some remainder and some quotient, and that too in these equivalent registers. So AX will get quotient, in DX will get remainder. So quotient will be 1, here it is 4. So this remainder we are interested in. What we are doing, we are checking whether it is between 0 to 9 or not. Yes, it is between 0 to 9, so we will add 30H and that will get stored here. So here my now number is 4, but ASCII, in ASCII format. Second iteration, now my AX value is 1, that will be carried forward as it is because we are not changing the value of AX. It will get divided by 16. So again my remainder and quotient will get calculated. So AX DX values. So here my now remainder is 1, quotient is 0. Again we'll check whether it is between 0 to 9 like this. Yes, it is between 0 to 9. We'll add it 30H into it and then we'll put it here. And like that we are getting 14 as an answer. Okay, so this is how procedures are written and executed in 64-bit assembly language program.